A little more now then on the outcome of that Mark Duggan inquest yesterday, still talking of course today, Mr Duggan, whose fatal shooting by police back in 2011 led to riots in London and of course in other English cities too. An inquest concluding yesterday that it was lawful killing. Commissioner of the Metropolitan Police, Sir Bernard Hogan Howe, has been meeting some community leaders today, and he's been talking about ways of trying to rebuild trust and rebuild confidence. And I'm joined now by someone who knows a lot about this area because he's done so much work in this area, Simon Woolley, director and founder of Operation Black Vote. Thank you so much for coming in, Simon.
Good
to see you. Can we just ask the basic question? What has this Duggan case done to perceptions among black community? Yeah.
Well, there's already been a gap between black communities and the police. I would say right now there's a gulf. So there's huge work to be done. And I guess trying to understand this whole complex issue, you need to have some background to it. First of all, stop and search, which is a real scourge for many in the black community. Tens of thousands of black youngsters going about their law-abiding business being stopped and searched. At best, this interaction with the police is negative. At worst, it's humiliation. That's the first thing. The second, of course, is that we've seen over a number of years some police lie. We saw it with Hillsborough, we've seen it with Stephen Lawrence, and we've seen it on other occasions too. And thirdly, an uncomfortable truth, but nevertheless relevant, is that sometimes juries get it wrong. We saw it with John Terry when he was acquitted for racially abusing another player. And we saw it with Alex McFarlane, a police officer who was taped actually verbally abusing a black man, only to be found not guilty because he argued he was having a philosophical discussion about the N-word. And so all of these things, they come together and I guess tell the black community that it's them and us. And this particular case with Mark Duggan, with so many conflicting issues around it, you just leave many in the community to feel, here we go again.
When we get Chief Superintendent Victor Olisa, who, let's face it, does know something about the black community in London,
for sure,
when he tells us that a lot of good work has been done, that he's giving very robust guidance to officers, they are revising the stop and search practices, are you convinced by the case he's making?
Well, I mean, we've been arguing that point when I was at the Equality and Human Rights Commission for a very long time. Actually, some of the uses of stop and search are completely ineffective and not catching criminals, and they're alienating great swathes of the black community. Evidence-led policing, policing by consent, engaging with communities is the only way forward, both for the community, the black community, and the police. And if the officer in Haringey is undertaken that way, that method, I think it can only be a positive thing. But right now, is this trust? And I know I heard the commissioner say that we must look forward, but it's very difficult to look forward when you've got an unresolved past. And when the Duggan family say that for them there's no peace, well, I hear that. I hear it's difficult to rest until you've reconciled some of these gross anomalies, this conflict of who did what. Until that's dealt with effectively, it's difficult to move forward.
When you talk about rebuilding confidence and rebuilding trust, let's have a few practical examples of how you would like to see, let's say, a force like the one in North London, in Tottenham there, trying to reach out, because in reaching out, they also need people to respond.
That's right.
And I suppose the question I'd ask you bluntly as well is, are people prepared to respond? Are they in the mood to respond?
Well, I think it right at this juncture, possibly no. I think it's going to take some time and some healing. But you do need that face-to-face conversation and building the trust and actually viewing people not as potential criminals, but actually as role models of citizens of a community, that everybody has a role to play. Once you engage in that, build the trust, then actually some young people may consider becoming police officers. We need more black police officers and more black senior police officers like the gentleman in Tottenham.
It's interesting you raise that point because, of course, it brings in employment. I'm just wondering, really, when we talk about disaffected youth, especially black youth, lots of them tell us all the time it's a lack of opportunity very often that makes them disengaged, that makes them distrust authority as well.
Yeah.
So what this case has done in a way, maybe, and you can comment on this, is that it's raised issues which are way beyond just relationships with police.
Of course, clearly there's a conversation about the police and policing, and I think everybody concerned recognises that the police have to do better, they have to be more honest. Just on that point, I think that if the police force said, look, we undertake many operations, but occasionally we get it wrong, I think the general public would accept that. But when they bunker down and say we did everything right, that's when the mistrust comes in. But in regards to the community...
And opportunities,
yes, look, we can have a vibrant, dynamic community, but people need opportunities. People need education, access to good education, access to jobs, to decent jobs, and then we can become dynamic and fulfilled citizens. But with the shocking levels of unemployment, particularly amongst black men, I think it's 60% in London, 25% white youths, 60% black youths, a shocking gap. If people are given jobs and opportunity, you will see less gangs and a better dynamic society.
Good to talk to you, Simon. Thanks for coming in again.
No problem.
Thank you very much indeed. Simon Woolley there, who is the director and founder indeed of Operation Black Vote. Thanks very much.